Hello all, I welcome you to my channel. Today I'm going to show you how to install MySQL Server on the Windows operating system. And I'm also going to show you how to install MySQL Shell and MySQL Workbench along with your MySQL Server. And after that, I'm also going to write a simple SQL program. So I'll show you how to create database, how to create table, how to insert data and everything. So, you know, keep watching. Do watch the video till the end. If you face any difficulty, do comment. I am always there to help you. And if you like the video, then please give it a like and also do share it with your friends. That will really help me to make more such videos. So, let's start our video. Now, to install MySQL, you need to first simply go to your favorite browser. And in the address bar, you need to just simply search with MySQL download. And hit enter. And you can see MySQL download is rightly shown. So just simply click on MySQL download. This will going to redirect to the official site of MySQL. You need to scroll down and you will get MySQL community GPL downloads over here. Just simply click on that. And here under MySQL community downloads, you need to click on MySQL installer for Windows. Okay, so just simply click on that and it will redirect to this page. And you can see latest version of MySQL installer is 8.0.32. So if you are, you know, watching this video much later and if you see this version are much higher than our current version, no big deal, it will going to work same. And if there is any difference on the latest version, I am going to, you know, make a new video on that. So here one thing you need to remember is that you need to download the one which whose size is like greater. So basically if you see here, MySQL installer community version is the one which we are supposed to download, not this web community one. Okay, so we need to download this one. So just simply click on this download button and just simply click on no thanks, just start my download. And there you go, it has rightly started downloading our latest version of MySQL. So let's wait for a couple of minutes to finish it download. So you can see our download is rightly completed. So you can just simply click on this installer and Windows is, you know, preparing to install. So let's minimize our download directory. So it will ask you for administrative privileges. Just simply click on yes. And it will again going to ask you for administrative privileges. Just simply click on yes. So you can see MySQL installer is, you know, started launching. So MySQL installer 1.6. And you can see it has rightly launched over here. So here, you know, you need to choose the custom one. I'm going to show you why we are choosing the custom. Just simply choose custom and click on next. And here you can see that we have, you know, available products. So you need to expand this MySQL server and you need to click on the MySQL server, latest version of MySQL server, which is 8.0.32. So just simply select that and click on this arrow to get it listed under product to be installed. Similarly, you need to do it for our Workbench. So Workbench will provide GUI interface, that is graphic user interface. So on that interface, we're going to, you know, work on our SQL programming. And I'll also recommend you to install MySQL Shell. So that is basically will provide you a command line interface. So on that command line, you can, you know, we can start SQL programming. Okay, so these three products is what you need to, you know, put it under products to be installed and just simply click on next. So you can see all three are ready to be installed. Just simply click on execute and there you go. See, it has started installing our three products. So welcome back. And now you can clearly see that our MySQL server, Workbench and Shell all are rightly installed. So you can just simply click on next. So now it's time to configure our MySQL server. So just simply click on next. And you can see that our development computer is rightly selected for configuration type and TCP IP. This is the important thing, the port number 3306. So you need to use this port number when you are establishing any connection with your, you know, front end application with back end. So MySQL uses this port number and all other things are fine. Just simply click on next. So here it is recommending to use a strong password. Just simply click on next. So here let's give the password. You can give, you know, any password. This is what you are using on your local system only. So a weak password does not matter. So this is our root user password. If you want to add user, you can just simply click on add user and you can, you know, create a new user over here. For now, I'm going to use the root user only. Just simply click on next. They're going to, you know, configure this MySQL server. Then the Windows MySQL service name is this. Everything is fine. Click on next. Again, next. And click on execute to start, you know, applying all this configuration. And now you can clearly see that our MySQL configuration are all rightly done. So you can just simply click on finish. And product configuration is complete, you can see. Just simply click on next. So now it's asking to start our MySQL workbench and MySQL shell. MySQL shell you don't need. Let's, you know, start with MySQL workbench. And you can see our MySQL workbench is rightly launched. So let's maximize it. And you need to click on this, you know, root user. So let's give the password you have, you know, given while creating our MySQL. You can save this password in the vault as well. Just simply click on OK. And you can see it has rightly connected. So this is our query window. So let's create a database first. So create database employee. So EMP, let's say. And just, you know, simply execute this statement. And you can see our database is rightly created. So let's create a table. So create table EMP, that is our database dot employee, and I'll be giving a couple of column over here. So first one will be EMP ID, and it will be int data type, and then full name is our, you know, next column with varchar 50 characters, let's say. So just simply execute our statement. And you can see that is, you know, rightly executed. Let's insert a couple of values. So insert into, you know, our two column name, EMP underscore ID, comma, full name, right? And then values, and inside values, we have ID 1 and full name. Let's give Shourav Ganguly. So here is our statement. So just simply execute it. So you forgot to select the database. So you need to type, you know, EMP dot employee. That is our database, then the table name. So just simply execute this statement, and you can see it has rightly inserted. So let's fetch the table, select star from EMP dot employee, select the statement, click on the run button, and you can see the output rightly shown. Employee ID, then full name Shourav Ganguly. So in this way, you can easily install the latest version of MySQL on a Windows operating system. And I have also shown you how to run a simple SQL program and how you can easily fetch the data on our workbench. So that's basically all about this video. Please do like, share, and subscribe.